Construction of the 30-meter telescope that has received all the necessary permits is set to begin this week. But those opposed to the project say they're not giving up. Hundreds gathered this morning blocking the Mauna Kea access road. Law enforcement officers seemed poised to arrest those blocking the road, but then stood down. Jen Boniza has been following this story and joins us now from Mauna Kea with the latest. Jen?
Joe, I'm alongside Mauna Kea Access Road, and right behind me you can see Department of Transportation vehicles now leaving Mauna Kea Access Road. Within the last couple of hours, a lot has happened. The DOT actually put up a gate blocking the entrance to Mauna Kea Access Road, and within the last half an hour, they then took it down, and they are now currently leaving the scene. Now, if we walk over this way, we can see that the Kia'i, or protectors of Mauna Kea, have once again gathered on top of Mauna Kea Access Road. They are attempting to block access to any of possible construction workers or anyone else that may come to try to gain access to the mountain. They have been here, some of them, since Sunday. It has been a long run for everyone, a very emotional day, a roller coaster of events and emotions. And no word yet or explanation as to why that gate was put up and then taken down so quickly. However, we will let you know as soon as we do why that happened. We're going to now take a look at what happened over the course of this very busy day.
My plan here is to kupa'a and protect Mauna Kea.
Billy Freitas and at least a dozen kupuna bound themselves together with Mailile across the base of Mauna Kea Access Road. Eight others chained themselves to a cattle grate further up the road. Their determination and message was clear.
We've already been informed that we will be arrested, which is something that we're willing to do as our kuleana. It's our burden as well as our privilege to show our children and the rest of the world how much we love our land, to show my students at home that things are worth fighting for.
And they continued to fight. In the early morning hours, it seemed as though police might make a move to arrest the kupuna. But were quickly confronted by protesters. But cooler heads prevailed. Communication between both sides was open throughout the day as police and those opposed to TMT negotiated the safest path forward.
Where we are committed to nonviolent and peaceful action, we're steadfast on that, and we're not going to allow anybody to jeopardize what we're trying to do.
Barriers were put in along Daniel Ke'inoe Highway to ensure that protesters could exercise their rights safely, but also to allow police and sheriffs to manage the crowds.
The concrete barriers are going to serve a couple of things. We won't have people parking on the highway anymore. And we'll also make sure that we have an area where people who want to express their feelings about this project can be behind and be safe on.
Since the protesters are unwilling to leave, it felt like it was only a matter of time before someone was arrested. Then, after 2 p.m., after almost 11 hours, officers relented.
The chief, the head of this faction, let us know that due to the longevity of this commitment, you know, the unwavering commitment of these Kia'i, they're backing off, they're retreating, they're going back up. And all those who were supposedly arrested at 3:30 this morning are going back to the Pu'uhonua.
What do you think it was that made the sheriffs finally say, we're not going to do this today?
I think it was the same thing that saved Kaho'olawe. It was aloha. That's what I feel on both sides.
It was hard. It was a difficult day, but I feel at the end of the day grateful to be alive, grateful to be standing for the Mauna, grateful to be a part of this amazing Lahui, this movement.
Today has been a very long day and just the first of what I'm sure will be many standoffs between both protesters and the police. So far, there have been no arrests here at Mauna Kea. We will continue to monitor the situation and bring you the latest. Just a note that they have concluded putting in the barriers along Daniel Ke'inoe Highway. And I am told that the road does continue to be open. However, traffic is slow going. As you can see, the protesters have once again placed themselves along Mauna Kea Access Road, and I'm sure they plan to stay there until morning. You can log on to KH12.com for the latest. Jen Bonizza live from Mauna Kea, sending it back to you, Joe.